Hello everyone, in this video we will learn about states of matter, lesson number 1, matter in our surrounding, class 9th. So whenever we observe different type of things in our surrounding, they are made up of matter. And we all know that matter are made up of either solid, liquid or gas. So whenever we are observing these type of states, so these type of states are just because of variation in the characteristic of particles in the matter. That means whatever the number of particles present in these type of matter decide that this matter will be a solid or it will be liquid or it will be in gas. So let's study about the properties of these three states of matter in detail. Now let's discuss about first the solid state. So collect some of the material like a pencil, a book, a piece of wood and a piece of iron. So these are example of solid. So whenever we are observing the properties of these type of solid, we can easily notice some of the features. For example, these type of materials are having a definite shape, these type of materials are having a fixed volume, and they are not deformed when we are applying force or pressure on them. So after that, we can easily say these type of materials that we call the solid are having a definite shape, definite volume, and they can easily resist the pressure or force that we are applying on them. But what happens when we are having a rubber band? So whenever we are having the rubber band, these rubber bands are quite elastic. So whenever we are applying the force on them, they can easily change their shape. And whenever we are removing that force, it can easily get the previous shape. Similarly, if we are having a sponge, in that case, these type of sponge are having a proper shape. But whenever we are applying the force on them, they can easily deform. The reason behind that, whatever the pores which are present in the sponges, these sponges are filled with air. And when we are applying the force, these air will be come out. And after that, whenever we are removing the force, it can easily gain the previous shape because the air will enter in these type of pores again. So what happens when we are having the sugar or salt? So when we fill the sugar or salt in a jar, it can easily take the shape of that vessel or a jar. So why it is? So the reason behind that, the sugar and salt particles are having a proper shape, but whenever we are putting this sugar or salt in a jar, it will take the shape of jar because they are arranging themselves in that jar. That means the shape of that sugar is quite small so that it can easily adjust according to the space that we are providing in the jar. Now let's discuss about the liquid state. So collect some of the materials or some of the liquid like water, milk, any type of juice and any type of oil also, or any cold drink also. Now take different type of containers and transfer these liquid around 50 ml in each of the vessel, and we have to observe some observation like, is these type of liquids are able to change their shape? Is the volume of these liquid will change? So after conclusion or after observation, we will find that these liquids are having a proper volume but not having the proper shape. That means whenever we are transfer the liquid into another container, it can easily get the shape of that container. Due to that, we can easily observe that these type of liquids do not have a proper shape. The reason behind that, the particles of these liquids are having a space between them. Due to that, they are able to flow. And just because these type of liquids are able to flow, we call them fluid. So whatever the things that are able to flow, we can say it is a fluid. So including the water and these type of liquids are also are fluid. Now another property of these type of liquids are they are able to diffuse, or they are able to diffuse other things in them. For example, if we observe different type of aquatic animals, so they are breathing through their gills, and these gills are able to take the oxygen, just the oxygen which is dissolved in the water. So if these type of things or any type of thing is not dissolving water, especially the oxygen or different type of gases, then the living organisms are not able to survive on Earth. Although different type of materials, especially the liquids, are able to diffuse very easily as compared to the solid. Solids are not having the space between them or having the very minute space between them. Due to that, they are not able to dissolve or they are not able to diffuse with other solids. But in liquids, they are having a sufficient amount of space so that they are able to diffuse in other liquid as well as in solid also. So if we are having the sugar or any type of other materials are also having, so these type of material can easily diffuse in the water very easily or in liquid very easily. Now let's discuss about the gaseous state. So we all know that we can easily fill lots of balloon by a single cylinder. That means if we are having a hydrogen cylinder, so by using that hydrogen cylinder, we can fill lots of balloon without any problem. The reason behind that, the space between the gases are much higher as compared to the solid or liquid. Due to that, they can easily filled in a small container. Now to prove this, we have to perform an activity. In this, we have to take 300 ml syringe and we have to close these nozzle by any cork. Now after that, we have to remove the piston and we have to leave one of the syringe untouched without filling any type of thing. That means we have to leave it without filling anything. In the second needle or in second syringe, we have to fill water. In the third syringe, we have to take a piece of chalk and we have to put in this syringe. After that, we have to apply the piston or we have to fix the piston in all these syringes and we will try to press it or we will try to compress it. So after that, we will easily see or we can easily observe that the piston which was empty, which is not having anything, it can easily compress. In the second one in which we are filling the water, it is having a very minute or very minimum amount of or very minimum compression. But in the third thing, which is filled with chalk, it will not compress at all. So by this, we can easily conclude that the solids are having the very minor space between them. The liquid are having little bit greater space as compared to the solid and the gases are having the highest space between them or the maximum space between them. Due to that, they are able to compress. For this, we are having different type of examples in our day-to-day life also. For example, the LPG that we are using in kitchen, they are liquefied petroleum gas. And these liquefied petroleum gas are filled in the cylinder in high pressure. Due to that, their particles come closer. Due to that, they are able to fill in a small jar very easily or in a small container very easily. Similarly, the CNG that we use in automobiles, they are also compressed natural gas. So these gases are also compressed at very high pressure in a cylinder so that it can easily transport. Now, if we compare the diffusion process or diffusion speed in gases, it is much higher as compared to the liquid or solid. The reason behind that, the particles of these type of gases are having huge space between them and due to that, they are randomly moving at very high speed and they are also applying some pressure on the wall of any container in which we are filling them. So due to that, whatever the pressure that is applied by the air on any type of material, so we called it air pressure. Now, just because the diffusion speed is much higher in gases, so that we can easily sense what is cooked in a kitchen. After that, also, if anyone is applying the deodorant or any type of perfume, then also the perfume aroma, it's easily mixed with the air and it will transfer very easily to us. That is why we are able to sense the smell or any type of other aroma very easily by the diffusion process which is occur in the gases. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.